the Space Coast economy is booming. And high-tech companies ranging from major firms like SpaceX and L3Harris to rapidly growing small businesses all share the same thing: a need for skilled workers to fill their ranks and fuel more growth. Eastern Florida State College is playing a central role in that effort by educating a new generation of high-tech workers that are changing the face of Brevard County's future. With career and technical programs such as aerospace and engineering technology, robotics, cybersecurity, and more, EFSC graduates are bringing state-of-the-art skills to the workplace. It's a top priority of College President Dr. Jim Ritchie, with some EFSC programs becoming state models for developing a high-tech workforce. One of EFSC's key partners is the Economic Development Commission of Florida's Space Coast, whose leaders see the college's programs as essential in tackling workforce shortages and attracting new companies.
How the EDC and Eastern Florida partners has been transformative over the last few years. At first, I think it was us being aware they're on the board, they're aware of what we do, we're aware of what they do, and it was, this is great. But as the need for training and workforce is ever-increasing demands, so has our relationship with Eastern Florida's gotten far more sophisticated.
Eastern Florida State College works closely with the Economic Development Commission to help ensure existing and new businesses have the workforce they need. We meet with local businesses and those looking to relocate to the area to understand their needs and make sure our curriculum is consistent with those needs.
A prime example of where the college's efforts are paying off is at Kennedy Space Center, where commercial space companies are reinventing human spaceflight. Among them is Lockheed Martin, where EFSC students in aerospace technology serve apprenticeships, doing hands-on work on the Orion spacecraft that will take astronauts back to the moon and on journeys to Mars.
The apprenticeship program, as part of a two-year degree, allows students to be selected and literally work with us here on the floor developing and building the Orion spacecraft. And that is their foot in the door. It's great for us. Eastern Florida State College brings that talent forward from the pipeline and gives them a landing spot so that the team can literally hit the ground running. And it's been a great partnership and we really do appreciate that.
So the apprenticeship program at the time when I was part of it, it was people who had graduated from the program who were picked by the professors and other people in the program to come out here and work part-time, paid, to learn the skills needed to transition to a full-time position out here on the space program. Part of the reason why Eastern Florida joined up initially for the apprenticeship program was to help fill the talent gap. A lot of the people that were working out here at the time were part of the shuttle program where we're getting ready to retire, and they saw the need to bring in new people before the shuttle folks retired so they could pass on their knowledge and their skill sets.
I graduated from Eastern Florida with my AA, and I was looking to go to a four-year college to major in mechanical engineering. I started my first semester at the four-year program, and I didn't know if it was for me, so I went back, told my mom, I was like, nah, I think I'm thinking about the Eastern Florida State program. Ended up doing that. I love the hands-on. I think it's a lot different than going to a four-year degree first. So to get the hands-on experience, I think is much more critical.
There are always opportunities to come out here and work on the Orion program. We're constantly looking to refresh the talent pool.
The college also has a strong partnership with Airbus US Space and Defense, where EFSC apprentices and graduates are using skills they learned in mechatronics, robotics, and other fields to build a fleet of satellites at the company's KSC facility that will improve global connection to the internet.
About 35 years ago, I was an apprentice. So straight away, that's something which I can automatically relate to. I think there's no better way to learn about an industry. It can be our great industry, it can be cooking, unless you do an apprenticeship program.
We started working in manufacturing very shortly after we became employed, and very shortly after we joined the apprenticeship. It was almost an immediate turnaround of joining the apprenticeship, becoming an employee, and working on satellites. So 18 years old, right out of high school, I was manufacturing satellites, and we actually had our first launch from our Merritt Island built satellites just a couple days before my 19th birthday. So 18 years old, I had 36 satellites up in space that I helped build.
A common thread for high-tech firms is a demand for technicians trained in advanced manufacturing. And here too, EFSC is a leading supplier of those workers.
Any company that's going to be successful is going to be involved in advanced manufacturing. So advanced manufacturing is key to us because the companies that exist here that particularly have to supply the Department of Defense in many ways demand that. So we have got to be involved and be ready with a workforce in advanced manufacturing.
Every local company here that we deal with, our industry partners, they are starving for young talent. The reason why this is such a high demand, in my opinion, there's unfortunately a lot of people my age that are retiring, and there is a shortage of the skilled trades. So the students that graduate from here, our companies are ready to hire them as soon as they're ready to go.
We live in a digital age, which makes it crucial to protect data from industrial espionage, ransomware, and other threats. On EFSC's Palm Bay campus, the Center for Cybersecurity and Digital Forensics is providing digital detectives for area companies. Its programs carry impressive credentials, with the center having gained the prestigious designation from the National Security Agency as a National Center of Academic Excellence in Cybersecurity.
In 2022, we were designated as an NSA Center for Academic Excellence. And that means that we provide the labs and the curriculum that the NSA deems worthy of a cybersecurity institution. And with that designation now, our students know that they're getting the best education possible in our area for cybersecurity. And it helps open them up to different job opportunities. There are specific jobs that only employers will allow a CAE student or alumni to apply for, so that helps that. Currently today, there's around 600,000 open positions in cybersecurity. So we are at a crisis mode for looking for those individuals who have experience in cyber, experience in IT in general. In Brevard County, there's around 2,000 open positions, and Florida itself about 32,000, according to cyberseek.org. So those are rough estimates, and it's also based on what type of people are have certain certifications and those open positions that they're looking at different job placement websites.
High-tech education requires the latest in high-tech facilities, and Eastern Florida is building on its success by investing in major new training centers. On the Melbourne campus, construction is starting on a new $20 million center for innovative technology education. This facility will set a regional standard for tailored programs to meet the specific workforce needs of high-tech companies. On the COCO campus, a new advanced technology center is taking shape for training in a range of programs focusing on the needs of commercial space companies. And on the Titusville campus, a new aerospace center of excellence has opened its doors with the first class of dual-enrolled high school students getting a jump start on their careers.
It's not as high maintenance as an actual dual enrollment class, so you're able to get a feel for it if you want to do this. And also, the aerospace program is so hands-on that you're able to learn as you go, and the professors are always willing to help you out, and you feel like you're able to talk to them. Being able to take aerospace classes through dual enrollment is just amazing, and I'm so happy I'm here for it.
Eastern Florida State College offers programs on each of our four campuses and online to meet local workforce needs. Whether it's associate or bachelor's degrees, short-term training certificates, industry certifications, or customized training for business and industry, we strive to give our students multiple options to meet local workforce needs.
From one end of the Space Coast to the other, EFSC is the go-to place for high-tech education and training. As the demand for skilled workers keeps increasing, the college will continue to work with its industry partners to ensure the workforce is second to none.
Affirmative. I have a quick and green light. Lock tagging secured.
Lock tagging secured.
I still don't know if I've fully wrapped my head around the enormity of working on the Orion project. It's manned space flight. We're going back to the moon. And to think that I have a part of that is a lot.
So of the 618 satellites that we have in orbit, I was here and helped with 612 of them. All the ones that were produced here in our Maritime Island facility.
Eastern Florida State College, the sky is truly the limit.